lift the farmers, to help the indigenous people, especially the IPs within our area, north of Tabato in Carmen, to help uplift their lives and offer them a better future and better lives, especially for their children. So our company does a lot of coconut byproducts, and we've moved on now to banana chips. So a few of our products are coconut sugar, virgin coconut oil or VCO, banana chips coated in coconut sugar and fried VCO. We have coconut wine as well, aminos, and a few others. I guess our company, you can consider us as a social entrepreneur. We want to not only bring business, but also to help uplift people's lives within our areas. Within our area, when we started out farming, a lot of the farmers or a lot of the people within that area didn't have any jobs, or they didn't know what to do, or their jobs were like every 3 months they'd have crops and then they'd later on sort of not have a job. But what we wanted to offer them was a stable and secure source of living. So right now a lot of our farmers have stable jobs, they've been able to send their children to schools, and later on we've also helped and empowered women as well, because a lot of our workers, especially during in producing our products, we rely on the women to do all those. So we support women, we hope to support also the greener and natural living here in the Philippines, the greener Philippines, the natural and organic market, and yeah, we just hope that everyone can see that. Especially us who live in a very high-risk area and a lot of like war zone areas. North Cotabato, Carmen, in the early 2000s was considered a war zone. But now like we want to help and show everyone and inspire them. Our areas can become something more productive, something that which helps the community and also helps bring livelihood to everyone.
Tree Life as a company, we are located in conflict-affected areas. The area is branded as a war zone. Would you believe that we don't even hire armed bodyguards or armed guards there? It's the farmers who are protecting us. In fact, a lot of our organic certified farms, organic coconut certified farms, are owned by MILF family combatants. And there's no risk for our certifiers to go there. You know, you just give them the opportunity to earn, respect their rights, and I believe they will be helpful. It's not that we are in the rural area. We're in, there is no chance for getting into the international market. In fact, our company Tree Life worked with the Dutch government under the CBI program to get our products into Europe. Right now, our coconut sugar is one of the top suppliers for chocolates in Europe as an ingredient. We also launched our premium VCO, freshly processed from our farm. And we also have our premium coconut wine. Maybe it's the first in the market. And now the US and European companies are trying to get exclusive distribution. So there is potential with Philippine agriculture. Just don't be too discouraged. There is future, but we have to move forward. We have to do away with always commenting on something, but we have to do something out of what is happening in our communities. What we're doing is just one of a few steps an entrepreneur should do. And don't think of us as doing this easy. There's no an easy way of doing business in the Philippines. But if you believe that there is future for our farmers, if you want to have a social impact, go to the rural areas. There is future there. In fact, we have difficulty getting financing before. But suddenly, Land Bank came in. Join us, partner with us, because we have a good story. And this year, a foreign-based company would like to finance our fair trade certification, because they learn and they understand and they are happy that we're helping farmers, improving their lives. We might not be looking at solving medium-term development goals of letting farmers earn more than the poverty threshold, but foreign people understand and watch what we're doing, and we're very happy that we're doing something for the farmers. So most of our farmers are composed of tribe people, the IP, the Manobo, Aroman and Manobo, the Muslims and the Christians. And right now we are living a quiet, happy life, peaceful, in our own struggles and in our own way of collaborating, understanding each one's rights. So hopefully as we move forward, a lot of companies will understand our story, be happy to hear our story, and consumers will patronize our product. In so doing, we are slowly generating more consumers, more people to patronize our product, and in so doing, we will be increasing not just 800 farmers, but maybe more than 5,000 farmers are coming soon. Hope should always be there, and we should not just do things lightly. We should be serious of what we're doing. I'm very happy now with the government for facilitating the farm-to-market roads directly to the farmers. It helps a lot in terms of bringing the food, bringing the raw material much cheaper to the plant. So don't just blame the government. Appreciate what they are giving. If they have shortcomings, we'll just say it frankly with those people running it that this is what we should do, and they are also very much ready to listen. So hopefully our experience as a company, Tree Life, will also duplicate or triplicate or maybe copied by other companies, and we'll be happy for that because we will be helping rural poverty